We are going to be making meatloaf later in three different kinds. Well, actually four, maybe, if you think about it. But before we do that, I thought we would do one of my favorites. And I wanted to make it earlier, but the stores were out of puff pastry. Hello, Linda. And they were out of everything bagel seasoning. So we are only using three ingredients for what I'm calling everything puff sticks. Everything puff sticks. You will need a sheet of puff. That's, I know it's backwards, but puff pastry sheets in the freezer section. You will need everything bagel seasoning. This is not the original from Trader Joe's, because I didn't have that. So I had to order this on Amazon. That's who I ordered it from. And you'll need some melted butter. Melted butter. Okay, so it comes, when you open these up, they come in sheets in this little thing, and they're folded. You just want to unfold it. So see, that's what I've done. I unfolded it. You don't need extra flour. You don't have to roll it out. You don't have to do anything else, because remember, Lazy Cindy, we melted like a tablespoon of butter, okay? Now, I have my little, I have a pastry brush, but if you don't have a pastry brush, that's fine. You can, hey Lisa, hey Joanne, hey Bev. If you don't have a pastry brush, use the back of a spoon, you know, spoon a little bit on. Okay, so all we're going to do is butter, yum, because who doesn't love butter? We're going to butter the puff pastry. Oh, it's singing. The puff pastry says, I was lovely beforehand, but now life is too good. Okay, so that's it. That was all it took, buttering the puff pastry. We did that. Now, everything seasoning. And you're just going to sprinkle it on. How much, you say? Oh, come. Now, you know I don't measure. You're just going to sprinkle it on here. You can make a big mess until you cover the whole thing. I should not use the shaker and just open the other end and dump, huh? No. We're just going to shake all the way around. La, 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 la. This could be your exercise. Shake, shake, shake. Shake, shake, shake. Shake your seasoning. Shake your seasoning. Okay, now, it's all covered, but really, I love this stuff. It's got a lot of garlic, and as you can tell, if you've cooked with me before, you know that I am a big garlic girl. Okay. Hey, maybe this would help, you know, as you get older, you get the swinging porch, the front porch on your arm right here. Maybe that would, no, maybe not. Okay, so covered with everything bagel seasoning. So see what it looks like? Oh, I forgot my pizza cutter. I'm gonna have to go get my pizza cutter. Hold on 1 second. All right, so because you put the butter on there, it's gonna stick. So you don't need to worry about that. Pizza cutter. You don't have a pizza cutter? Use a knife, okay? So now I'm cutting this into strips. Doesn't matter which direction you go, because it's basically a square. Now, I do them about a half an inch, I would guess. I'm not a good measurer, am I? At least I'm trying not to be the drunk pizza cutter today. Yesterday with the dumplings, it looked like I was, the way I cut those, that dough made me look like a drunk person. Okay, now, baking sheet, parchment paper. Why do I use parchment paper? Because I don't want it to stick and I don't want to have to wash afterwards, okay? So now you just take your strips and lay them out. Leave a little room between each of them because remember, this is puff pastry dough. What are we making? Hey, Kathy. Hey, Terry. Hey, Tasha. Linda, I called these everything puff sticks. So it's puff pastry dough brushed with butter and topped with everything bagel seasoning. That's it. How easy is that? The oven is already, whoops, I need more room. Move. The oven is already preheated. The package instructions say 400. The only thing I'll tell you, these cook pretty quick, so keep an eye on them. Okay, so there we go. And we're just gonna pop them in the oven. And then we'll start our meatloaf. Okay, sticks are in. Those are gone. Now to the meatloaf. I gotta move this too. Okay. If you cooked with me before, you know that I normally buy, because I'm cheap, I buy big old tube of meat. I know. But the grocery stores are a little low on meat. It's very hard to find. So, ended up, I bought three of just these regular, this is a pound. Each of these is a pound. So now, it depends. Normally, if I'm cooking for my family, I can probably get by with a pound of hamburger meat. Your family may be much larger, or maybe they eat more, or maybe you like to make extra for sandwiches, so maybe you want to use more. But because we're doing a couple of different ones, hey Joe, am I feeling better? Yes, I'm feeling better. Still not 100%. I don't know why it takes so long for my body to recover. I think maybe, we had a storm last night, and the storms are just, they kill me too. It just makes everything curl up and ache. And we lost power last night. We lost power. I mean, it went off, on, off, on, off, on, and then it went out. It was out for like 45 minutes. Okay, well, you know, I survived all the hurricanes when we didn't have power for days. Not really a big deal. We have these cool little, it's not in here more. We have these cool little lanterns by our bedside tables, all of us, because after this has happened several times. Okay, here it is. See this little doodah? And then you just pull it up. Ta-da! Lantern. So we're fine if the lights go out, not a problem. But not only did the lights go out, and of course your Wi-Fi goes out, right? Okay, so that's fine. I got that. But on four, you know, when you put it on you turn Wi-Fi off and you're just using your 4G, that went out. No internet. I was certain the Russians were coming, or the Chinese were coming, or the Taliban, somebody was coming, because we had no electricity and no internet. Ah! It was all fine. It all came back on. Okay. Remember how yesterday when we were making the dough and I said I don't like to get my hands icky? For the most part, I can do icky hands. I don't like it, but I can do it. But hamburger meat is a whole different ball of wax. I don't like it. It's gross. So, see, I have these little plasticky gloves. I know you're saying, what a wuss you are. Stick your hands in the hamburger meat and it will be just fine. And maybe that's so. And yet, I'm not doing it, using the gloves. Okay, so I've got 3 pounds of hamburger meat in this big bowl. The very first thing we're going to do, and we're using my mother's recipe. Everybody's meatloaf recipe is probably different. That's fine. Just giving you some options. So when we get done, you will have basically four different meatloaf recipes. Okay? All right. So basic is what I'm starting with. Again, 3 pounds because I'm doing so many different things. You probably just want one. If you're just using a pound of hamburger meat, you just need one egg. Because I'm doing three, I don't necessarily need 3 eggs, but I do, in fact, need at least 2. Why do you use egg? Because you need a binder. The egg works as a binder to hold it all together, to hold the meat together. Okay? Next, I'm going to go ahead and season with just some salt and pepper. Okay? You're always asking measurements. I know. And you know my answer is usually, a teaspoon, a half a teaspoon, about that. Now, the next thing we need in here is something to extend our meatloaf and to give it a little huh to it, right? Hi, Eileen. Hey, Sherilyn. Hey, Julie. Hey, Julie, I hope you had a good birthday. It looked like you had a lot of fun, even though you were quarantined. So when I was growing up, and still to this day, you didn't go to the grocery store and you could not find something called breadcrumbs, right? That was not something you found. You either dried out bread, right, and crumbled that up, or what my mother did was she took saltine crackers and she would smush all the saltine crackers up and she would put saltine crackers in here. I know, I'm just, hey Judy, I can't, the hand. So anyway, she always used saltine crackers. I've kind of gotten the habit of using breadcrumbs, but either works. Okay, you're gonna ask how much. And again, I never measure, but I got the spoon or the cup out just because I know you would ask. So, I'm gonna put two cups. Two cups. Now, the like I said, one of the reasons they started putting crackers or breadcrumbs or bread into the meatloaf was to make it go further. Because remember, meatloaf was born at a time where we didn't have a lot of money, we didn't have a lot of anything. And so we're trying to make the meat go further. And so the more cracker or bread or whatever you put in there, the more stuff you have. And so you can feed your family on less actual meat. Some people saute onions and peppers and put that in there. That's fine. That's not how my mom did it originally. Now you say, okay, we've got two eggs in there to bind it, and we have all this meat, and the breadcrumbs, that's going to be really dry. And the answer is yes. Now, again, using my mother's recipe, hey, Sue, I'm using evaporated milk, not condensed milk. That would be nasty. Sweetened condensed milk, too sweet. Ugh. I mean, I love sweetened condensed milk, but not my meatloaf. You could use regular milk. That's fine. This is just what my mom always used. And so that is what I'm using. Evaporated milk. Okay. Now you say how much? This is a 12-ounce can. I probably will not use the whole 12-ounce can. When I'm making it for my family, I get the little can. But they didn't have the little can, so all we have is a big can. Okay, you ready? If you are not grossed out by meat and ick and egg, you just go on in with your hands. Mama here is using the gloves. Okay, could you use a spoon? You could, but it's going to be very difficult because, I don't know, with the meat, I think it's going to be too hard. Does anybody make meatloaf and not use your hands? Like, do you use a spoon or a spatula? I'd be interested to know if that works for you. I probably needed a bigger bowl. Would you say, Cindy, that bowl is huge? And I know it is, but 3 pounds of hamburger meat is a lot of hamburger meat. Okay, so I'm smushing. Oh, and I'm throwing meat around. Nobody is saying that they use their hand or they use a spoon or a spatula. So I'm going to guess that everybody uses their hands. You kind of have to, this is great for your kids. I mean, if your kids, maybe I didn't as a child get mushy enough. Although I was just always grossed out by it. This would be great for your kids because they can kind of smush it in their hands. Hands. Hey, Kathy. Jazz hands all the way. Sarah. Hello, Sarah. Oh, Sarah is another of the, from Enid. She was on the Bells of the Plains too. She was one of my lieutenants. Oh, Sarah, so good to see you. So, okay. The drill team. I say Bells of the Plains, that was my high school drill team. Okay, there, that's good enough. That's as good as I'm mixing, okay? It's a little dense, but I'm okay with that. Nope, I'm gonna add just a little bit more milk. Because I don't want my meatloaf to be dry. That would be disgusting. You want your meatloaf to be all yummy. Oh yeah, see, this is much better. Okay, just needed a little bit more evaporated milk. Don't make that mistake and go to the store and looking at the milks in the baking aisle and grab that sweetened condensed milk. It would be gross. My husband makes the meatloaf. Use your hands without gloves. I know. Okay, see, that's better. Okay, now I'm going to show you what it looks like because you're going to go, really, Cindy? It looks, it almost has a white tinge to it. Do you see? Can you tell that? I don't know if you can tell that or not. But it's not like red meat right now. Now it's kind of got a little white tint. Okay, now you say, why? Okay, that's the basic meatloaf recipe right there. That's it. You can take this and form it into a loaf pan and bake it. Some of you grew up with the tomato sauce on the top, and you can do that. And that's perfectly fine meatloaf. Bah! However, let me see if I can, which hand? Okay, I'm going to take this one off. The reason, 2 out of 3, we need our song. Okay, we do not have the rights to this song. Look at this dish I got. It's 3 in 1. 3 in, wait, can you hear this? don't you have to love Meatloaf?
Where's my salt shaker?
Okay, there you go. That was my Meatloaf karaoke, except I didn't do it very. Okay, so anyway, I just thought this was the coolest dish. Now, I would normally, I could use this like for when we're doing tacos and put lettuce, tomato, cheese, right? So this is good. Or different veggies. So I like this. But when I was thinking about today, I was like, what a great idea. We could do meatloaf three ways. My kids would eat it as meatballs, but not meatloaf. Oh, you know what you could do, Sherilyn? You might also do, barbecue sauce on the top. That's another one. Do a mini loaves. Buy the little mini loaf pans, and then they have their own little individual meatloaf. Maybe they would do that. My kids would do that, but not the big slices. Anyway, okay. So, I'm not making Plano. The first meatloaf we're going to make is bacon cheeseburger meatloaf. That's the first one we're making. Bacon cheeseburger meatloaf, yes. Okay, so this is what we're going to do. If I was making one meatloaf and I had my meatloaf, look, this is like my meatloaf bowl. That was what I would make meatloaf in, 9 by 7-ish, somewhere between five and seven. Meatloaf dish. This is what I would make meatloaf in, pound of hamburger meat, okay? So if I was doing that, I would take half of my meat and put it in the bottom of the bowl, bottom of the baking dish. We're making several, so I'm gonna grab a handful and press it into the bottom of my baking dish. La la la, still with the glove, because come on, oops, I need a little bit more. A little gross. Okay, I've shoved it down, hello, all along the sides. And then I'm just gonna take my two fingers and make a little bitty well. Hold on, so you can see. Okay, so you see I have it in the bottom, and then just take your two fingers and kind of go like that and make just a little bitty well in the bottom of the meat. Okay, did you make your well? Okay, now with the well, we're gonna take cheddar cheese, just shredded cheddar cheese. And we're gonna take the shredded cheddar cheese and put it there in the well. You can go a little crazy. You can make it go almost to the edge. Okay, but not to the edge, because we want it all in there, okay? There we go. Cheese in there, cheddar cheese. Now, you would take the rest of your hamburger, of your meatloaf mix, and you would put it on top. Oh, I really need the glove back. Hold on. Okay, got it. All right, so I would go ahead and kind of shape it because I don't want to mess the cheese up. Look, see? Ta-da! And I'm going to plop that on the top. Plopping it on the top. Top. And then you just seal it all the way around. So when I say seal, that just means push it down. Push the meat so that you can't see any cheese. No cheese. Cheese is hidden. Why do we do this? Ooh, because when it cooks, the cheese is gonna melt all inside there. And when you slice the meatloaf, ooey gooey cheese is gonna come all out. Oh, you are going to be loved. Loved, I tell you. Now, what do we do next? Because it's bacon cheeseburger. So, we're gonna take our bacon. I have to tell you, my hands are getting really, I'm having to touch a whole bunch of really disgusting things today. Disgusting, I tell you. Come on, bacon. Okay, piece of bacon. Where are my scissors? Let me see. Oh, can you just cut that? My kitchen scissors. Cut that. Smack her in half. There we go. Okay. Because I have a smaller pan. So, I'm going to put the bacon. Oh, but we should have lots of bacon. Mm-hmm. Hold on. Let me do one more piece, and then I'll show you what it looks like. bacon. Gross. My hands were in hamburger meat. Now they're in bacon. Okay. And then I will show you most beautiful, delicious, hello, bacon cheeseburger meatloaf. Okay. Lifting it up. Ta-da! There you go. All covered in bacon. So now that's going to cook. That meat underneath is going to cook. And when it's all done, you're going to slice down. You're going to get that bacon flavor, all the wonderful stuff we put in the meatloaf, and then that ooey gooey cheese is going to come out. Mmm, yum, 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 yum. Henrietta, do not let your husband fall. That would be bad. Hey, Catherine. All right, so we've made plain meatloaf, and we've made bacon cheeseburger meatloaf. Yay! Okay, now we're going to make the third meatloaf, okay? Bacon has to go away. Bye-bye, bacon. Okay. I'm going to have to move some of the meat into another bowl. Okay, because now I'm doing something. All right, so I'm going to use... This is like if you're going to make a Mexican. I know, you're like, Mexican? Really? Mexican meatloaf? Here's what I figure. I figure you've been cooking now for 23 days, or at least 2 weeks, right? And you're kind of going, oh, I need something else. I need, okay, these are going to have to go, aren't they? Doggone it. Because I just can't do everything with one hand. Okay. Here we go. Okay. So, we have part of our meat in a separate bowl. If you were just making the Mexican meatloaf, here you go. Just trying to give you some different ideas. We are going to add some ground cumin. Okay. I would add at least a half a teaspoon of ground cumin because that smells like Mexican food. Oh, so good. And then I'm also using smoked paprika. Yum! Smoked paprika is a little slice of heaven. Again, half a teaspoon. Okay, so now that that's in there, I gotta put the glove back on. I thought I could do it without the glove. That'll just gross me out. Okay, so now we're gonna mix that together. If you were making only the Mexican, you would have put those spices in before we did all the mixy, and it would already be all yummy in there and mixed up. But because we're doing four different kinds of meatloafs, had to do it a little separately. Okay. Just like the one we just did, we're going to take half of our meat and put it in our baking dish. Whether you're doing thirds like I'm doing, or the glove is coming off. Whether you're doing thirds, hey Vicky, hey Miss Henning, how's Soph? I know the girls got cut off last night when we had our power was out, and so that was bad. I can't stand touching raw meat either. Ick. I know. It's just nasty. Which is weird because I don't mind like when I have to do a roast or I have to do even chicken. I mean, I know a lot of people get all freaked out about chicken, right? That doesn't even really freak me out. It's just hamburger meat. Just or sausage. Ground sausage. That gives me the willies too. Okay. So now, it's getting heavier now. See, I put it in the bottom. Take your two fingers, press down the center to make just a little well, okay? Now, this is Mexican, so you could use any kind of Mexican cheese that you want. This is, I think it's three pepper, hold on. Hot pepper blend, because my husband likes spicy things. This is Monterey Jack cheese with jalapeno peppers. Woo, right? So this is the hot pepper blend. You don't have to use that. You can just use a Mexican blend, the queso blend, whatever you want, okay? So the shredded cheese, and I'm gonna use the good hand. Not that it matters, because it's all gonna be touching the meat here in a second anyway. Okay, so all the cheese, let's just dump that whole sucker in there. Okay, all the cheese in the center of the meatloaf. Can you see that? Let me see. Can you see that? Yeah, okay. In the center. Then we're going to take the rest of our meat, right? I'm putting the glove back on. Hold on. This is, you must be chuckling at me, right? The glove debacle. Okay. Now, because I want this to sit on top and I don't want to dislodge my, I got hamburger meat all over me. It could be flying, the flying hamburger meat. Okay, I'm just making it into kind of a square, kind of, because it's a rectangle, not a square, but there you go. All right, so kind of like a flat little patty. I'm going to lay that on top, and then I'm going to push down on the sides so that our cheese is all tucked in. It's like putting your cheese down for a lovely nap. And when it wakes up, it will be all ooey gooey and wonderful. Okay, so now that is the Mexican one. You have an option here. Some of you probably, your mom made meatloaf where you put the tomato sauce on top, right? So, or tomato paste. So this is what it is, tomato paste. And she would put the tomato paste on top, or barbecue sauce, something like that. And then it would create this little crust on the top. That was never one of my favorite things. So quite frankly, most of the time, I don't put stuff on the top of my meatloaf. But maybe you want to. Maybe that's how you grew up. And if that's the case, my suggestion would be a little picante sauce. Oh, I need a little spoon. Could you give me a little spoon, please? A little picante sauce. Because if you want something that cooks and gets ooey gooey on the top, what better Mexican flavor than a little picante sauce? Look at that. And so you can just coat the whole thing so that you have a picante crust, if you will. Or icing, kind of like making a cake. And icing it with salsa. Won't it be a great day when all this is over and we can go back and have free chips and salsa and queso and big adult beverages? Won't that be lovely? Okay, ta-da! There we go. So that's our second one. So we've made regular meatloaf. We have made bacon cheeseburger meatloaf. And now we have a Mexican meatloaf. We have a spot left. Look, so what's next? Our next is going to be, and I'm going to move it in here too. Hold on. You say, but then you're going to have a lot of meat left over. But remember, I'm feeding a whole bunch of folks right now. And so I got to make sure. Okay, so I'm going to move another wad of meat over. Let me get a little bit more. Okay, this is going to be our Italian meatloaf. Okay, so I'm going to add... This is just, oh, that says ground cumin, so that would be wrong. I'm going to add Italian herbs. That's all it is, Italian herbs. If you don't have something that says Italian herbs, and you have oregano and basil, you certainly, and garlic, you could certainly do that. Okay? All right, so Italian herbs. Here's something else you could do if you want. Because is there such a thing as too much cheese? And I say, probably not. If you have some Parmesan, hey Camille, hey Lenny, if you have some Parmesan, this is shaved Parmesan, because that's all I have. But you could take a little handful, I'm gonna kind of break it up, because you know, you could take some Parmesan cheese and put it in with the meat. Oh, cheese on cheese on cheese, Cindy? Yes, yes, cheese on cheese on cheese. All right, so now I'm gonna take this hand and mix up so that our meat has Italian herbs and now Parmesan cheese running all the way through it. Ugh. See, this is really, make your kids do this. Tell them it's home ec class. Of course, then they look at you funny and go, what is home ec class? I'll tell you a funny story. So my daughter is getting ready to take her AP test, advanced placement test. And normally they're 3 hours long, but because of this whole thing, they're having to do them here. They're only going to be, I don't know, I think it's like 30 minutes or 45 minutes. Anyway, not very long. And there's only two questions. So that means you got to get it right. Anyway, so she says, normally the first hour is multiple choice and the next 2 hours is free response. Mm. I went, what? Free response. That's what it's called. I said, you mean essay questions? No, Mom, free response. So there you go. You learned something today. If you are, your kids have already graduated. Half of our meat, let me shove this down a little bit so you can see. Half of our meat we're going to put in the bottom and smush that down in there with the still gloved hand. You'd think as long as I've been cooking that this wouldn't bug the crud out of me, but it still does. Okay, so now we have that down in there. And again, two fingers in the middle, just going to make a tiny little well. And now shredded mozzarella cheese, because we did put a little Parmesan in there, but now I'm going to put the shredded mozzarella cheese that will melt and be all ooey gooey in there. Okay, mozzarella. Then we're going to take, I got to put the glove back on because I got to make the patty now. I have to tell you, this back and forth thing is about, can you imagine working at the hospital where you have to take these on and put these on and take these off and put these on and take these off? That'd just drive me all day long, all day, to keep you safe. Okay, so I'm making my rectangle. And you don't have to do this, but here's the deal. If you just plop the meat on top and then try to move it all around, then you dislodge all of your lovely cheese. And your cheese is in bed, and it's getting ready to be tucked in. Look, we're putting the covers on top of our cheese, and then we're going to just push down on the sides so that our cheese is all tucked in. You don't see the cheese. The cheese is going to be all warm and ooey gooey in there. Yummy. Yummy. Okay. That being said, moving this along, I'm going to take this off again. Ugh. Just ick everywhere. So we put bacon on the top of this one. You certainly, you know what else you could have done? You could have, because somebody said they liked barbecue sauce on this one. You could have gone ahead and put the meat, then the cheddar cheese, then the meat, and then put a layer of barbecue sauce, and then put your bacon on top. Mm-hmm. Barbecue, bacon, cheeseburger, meatloaf, right? All right, then this one, we put hot pepper cheese, but you could just put Mexican cheese in the center, and we topped it with picante sauce. Now, this one is the Mexican one. I have to take that off. This is the Mexican one. So, Italian. We did Mexican already. This is the Italian one. And so, you certainly could do tomato paste. That would be fine. It's giving you the tomato flavor. If you have pizza sauce, you know, the little jars of pizza sauce, you could put that on top. I don't have pizza sauce, and I don't want to put tomato sauce. But I do have, now this says marinara, but basically, it's spaghetti sauce. I got to get another spoon. Hold on. All right. So I'm just going to use this. Now you say you're going to open that whole thing for a few spoonfuls. Yes, but I'll use it for something else. All right. So we're going to spoon that on the top, and any spaghetti sauce would work, right? And this is going to bake on the top. Oh, yum. It smells so good. I'm frosting the meatloaf like a cake. I was watching Call the Midwife. Does anybody watch Call the Midwife? I love Call the Midwife. Was it Call the Midwife I was watching? No. Wait. No. It wasn't Call the Midwife, although it's one of my favorite shows. It was this show. I think they only had one season or two seasons. Now I can't remember. But it was all about these women who worked in this bomb factory. Now I have to order that three-well dish from Rebecca. She had it on her show last night, Joanne. Cold ground beef is the worst to have in your hands. I agree. There we go. They all worked in this bomb shelter. Bomb shelter. They made bombs. A bomb-making factory. And I want to say it's based in Canada. Hey, Rebecca. So I want to say that the show's based in Canada, and they all worked in this. And so one of the classes that they teach, because, you know, the guys are gone, but money is scarce, and they still have to make do, is meatloaf. And it's, it's a brand new thing. Nobody's ever heard of meatloaf. Nobody's ever done it. And everybody's like, gross, nasty. And like, no one would ever eat that. That's kind of what the thing was. No one would ever eat that. And of course, now we eat meatloaf. Okay, so let's go over what we made. we made regular meatloaf, right? Because that's what we started out with. So the regular meatloaf was just our meat. We had eggs. We had breadcrumbs. We had evaporated milk, but you could use regular milk, and salt and pepper. And that was it. Smushed it all together. Meatloaf. Poof. Stick in a dish, stick in the oven, you got meatloaf. You want some tomato paste on top, you can do that. You want barbecue sauce on top, you can do that. Our second meatloaf was the bacon cheeseburger meatloaf. So we put our we used our regular basic meatloaf mix, put half of our meat in the bottom of the tray, made a well with two fingers in the center, put cheddar cheese, put the rest of our meat on top of that. Of course, if you wanted barbecue bacon cheeseburger, you could put a little barbecue sauce. And then we layered our bacon. Can you see that? We layered our bacon on the top. Our second one, the one in the middle, is our Mexican meatloaf. So with that, we took our basic mix that we already had and we added cumin and we added smoked paprika. We mixed that all together. So we had those spices. Again, half in the bottom of our dish, make a well with two fingers. And in this, I use the hot pepper shredded cheese. But of course, you could use a queso or any kind of Mexican blend. Into the well, then we took the rest of it and put it on top, sealed all our cheese in, and we topped this with salsa, picante sauce, whatever you want to call it. And then our last one was an Italian one. The Italian one, we added just Italian herbs, you know, a basic Italian herb blend. But if you don't have that, you could use oregano and basil. We also added a little Parmesan cheese in the meat mixture. We put half of it down, made a well in the center with our two fingers, and we added our shredded mozzarella cheese. Put the rest of the meat on top, and we topped this with marinara sauce, spaghetti sauce, pizza sauce, whatever your little heart desires and what is in your pantry. Now, you're gonna bake these. These are small-ish, but as a general rule, you're gonna bake meatloaf about 45 minutes for about a pound. You wanna look at it, pay attention, but you'll be able to see it getting a little crusty, and that's the good part. You want it, you know, crunchy on the outside. If you were gonna make just a regular meatloaf, like I said, where's my ruler? I lost my ruler. Anyway, if you're just going to make a regular meatloaf, this is my regular meatloaf pan, okay? Like I said, this is 9 by 5 to 7. Oh, look, here's the ruler. All right. This is, I should know this, because this is, I have like 5 of these. This is 9 by 6. Oh, see, I said somewhere between 5 and 7. And there you go. So I would just put the whole thing in here, which is great. The wonderful thing about all of these recipes is once they're done, you take your little spatula or whatever and take it out. You can put it on a platter. So pretty. Once you slice it, all that ooey gooey cheese is going to run out. So when our bacon is going to crisp up and then that cheddar cheese is going to run out. The Mexican one, we're going to have that salsa that's baking on the top. The breadsticks are coming, Doris. I'm going to show you. Hey, Annette. The salsa is going to kind of bake onto the top. And when we slice that, all that ooey gooey hot pepper cheese or Mexican cheese is coming out. And then on our last one, our marinara sauce is going to bake bubbly on the top. And then when we cut into that one, the ooey gooey mozzarella cheese is going to come out. So four meatloaf recipes you got today. Basic meatloaf, bacon cheeseburger meatloaf, Mexican meatloaf, and Italian meatloaf. But you say, where are the puff, no, the everything puff sticks that we made in the beginning? So this is what we made in the beginning. I'm going to move our meatloaf just a little bit. If you like this dish, last night Rebecca from More Polish Pottery actually featured this on her Facebook Live, the three pan. And then she's having another Facebook Live tonight at 6. So if that's something that you'd like to watch, please tune in, More Polish Pottery. Okay, here's our sticks. Remember when we did our sticks, all we used is a package of puff pastry sheets, We brushed them with butter, and then we used the everything bagel seasoning and sprinkled that on top. We used the pizza cutter and sliced it up, Put them on a piece of parchment paper on a baking dish and stuck them in the oven. And here we go. Look at that. Look how fun that is. It's all puffed up. It's got all that goodness on there. Watch this. Sorry. Oh my gosh. You should be here. This is so good. That garlic flavor. And the puff pastry is just like little pillows. I know I'm gonna need my coffee. Little pillows on there. You have to make these. These are one of my favorite things. I have to use my new coffee cup in case you missed it earlier. Wildflowers. Okay, I ate one. I know, I love that pan too, Sherilyn. So anyway, there we go. Yesterday's show was so long, and it's all Sherilyn's fault, because I swore I'd never make chicken and dumplings, because it takes so long. But we did make chicken and dumplings, and we ate them all. Can you believe it? I didn't take any to the boys, because I knew. I double-batched it, and the girls and I ate them all. All. Like, everybody had two or three bowls. Gone. Gone. We're dumpling pigs over here. Tonight, though, I have enough meatloaf that the boys can have some meatloaf. And I think I'll make one more. These are great just for snacks. I mean, you don't have to eat these with dinner or lunch. You can just sit and eat these. These are good. So, that's all we have for today. I don't know anything else. Except, I'm really glad you guys are all here. I have fun seeing everybody's names. I was really glad Sarah was on today because I hadn't seen Sarah before. That's like the third belle of the plane that I've seen on here. So that's kind of cool. I know you're appreciative, Sherilyn. Anyway, so tomorrow is Saturday. So we will be on tomorrow for Saturday. I have some great, great stuff for tomorrow. Cheese and chocolate. Together or not? You will see. Cheese and chocolate tomorrow. So I hope you stay safe. I hope you have a great day. And above everything else, by the time tonight hits, your kitchen should smell oh so wonderful with either basic meatloaf, bacon cheeseburger meatloaf, Mexican meatloaf, or Italian meatloaf. And of course, these yummy everything puff sticks. Have a great day, and we'll sing one more time. You ready? Did you like at least two out of the three? I'll sing now. Ready?
'Cause two out of three ain't bad.
There you go. That's it. Good night. Tip your waiters. Have a great day. See you tomorrow.